Hello listeners, this is the fourth continuing video of Mahabharat audio series. In this video, I will be going through chapter number 4. It's about Devyani and Kutch. So let's begin with the chapter. In ancient times, there was a bitter struggle between the Devas or gods and the Asuras or demons for the lordship of the three worlds. Both belligerents had illustrious preceptors. Brihaspati, who was the preeminent in the knowledge of Vedas, was the guiding spirit of the Devas. While the Asuras relied on Shukracharya's profound wisdom, the Asuras had the formidable advantage that Shukracharya alone possessed the secret of Sanjeevani, which could recall the dead to life. Thus, the Asuras who had fallen in the battle were brought back to life, time and again, and continued their fight with the Devas. The Devas were thus at a great disadvantage in their long-drawn-out war with their natural foes. They went to Kutch, the son of Brihaspati, and besought his aid. They begged him to win his way into the good graces of Shukracharya and persuade him to take him as a pupil. Once admitted to intimacy and confidence, he was to acquire by fair means or foul the secret of Sanjeevani and remove the great handicap under which the Devas suffered. Kutch acceded to their request and set out to meet Shukracharya, who lived in the capital city of Brishparva, the king of the Asuras. Kutch went to the house of Shukra and after due salutation addressed him thus, "I am Kutch, the grandson of the sage Angiras and the son of Brihaspati. I am a Brahmacharin seeking knowledge under your tutelage. It was the law that the wise teacher should not refuse a worthy pupil who sought knowledge of him." So Shukra acceded and said, "Kutch, you belong to a good family. I accept you as my pupil, and more willingly that by doing so, I shall also be showing my respect to Brihaspati." Kutch spent many years under Shukracharya, rendering to perfection and prescribed duties in the household of his master. Shukracharya had a lovely daughter, Devyani, of whom he was extremely fond. Kutch devoted himself to pleasing and serving her with song and dance and pastime and succeeded in winning her affection without detriment, however, to the woes of Brahmacharya. When the Asuras came to know of this, they became anxious. As they suspected, the Kutch's object was somehow to wheedle out of Shukracharya the secret of Sanjeevani. They naturally sought to prevent such a calamity. One day, as Kutch was engaged in grazing the cattle of his master, the Asuras seized him, tore him into pieces, and cast his flesh to the dogs. When the cattle returned without Kutch, Devyani was filled with anxiety and ran to her father with loud lamentations. "The sun has set," she wailed, "and your nightly fire sacrifice has been performed. Still Kutch has not returned home. The cattle have come back by themselves. I fear some mishap has befallen Kutch. I cannot live without him." The fond father employed the art of Sanjeevani and invoked the dead youth to appear. At once, Kutch came back to life and greeted the master with smiles. Asked by Devyani the reason for his delay, he told her that as he was grazing the cattle, the Asuras came suddenly on him and slew him. How he came back to life, he knew not. But come back to life he did, and there he was. On another occasion, Kutch went to the forest to pluck flowers for Devyani, and again the Asuras seized and killed him, and pounding his body to a paste, mixed it up in sea water. As they did not return even after a long time, Devyani went as before to her father, who brought Kach back to life by his Sanjeevani and heard from him all that had taken place. For the third time again, the Asuras killed Kach and very cleverly, as they thought, burnt his body, mixed the ashes in wine and served it to Shukracharya, who drank it, suspecting nothing. Once more, the cows returned home without their keeper, and once again Devyani approached her distressful appeal for Kach. Shukracharya tried in vain to console his daughter. "Though I have again and again brought back Kach to life," said he, "the Asuras seem bent upon killing him. Well, death is a common lot, and it is not proper for a wise soul like you to sorrow at it. Your life is all before you to enjoy with youth and beauty and the goodwill of the world." Devyani deeply loved Kach, and since the world began, wise saws have never cured the ache of bereavement. She said, "Kach, the grandson of Angiras and the son of Brihaspati, was a blameless boy who was devoted and tireless in our life. I loved him clearly, and now that he has been killed, life to me has become bleak and insupportable. I shall therefore follow in his path." And Devyani began to fast. Shukracharya, heart shrunken by his daughter's sorrow, became very angry with the Asuras and felt that the heinous sin of killing a Brahmin would weigh heavily on their fortunes. He employed the Sanjeevani art and called upon Kach to appear. By the power of the Sanjeevani, Kach, dispersed as he was in the wine which was inside Shukracharya's body at the time, regained life, but prevented by the peculiarity of his location from coming out, he could only answer to his name from where he was. Shukracharya exclaimed in angry amazement, "O Brahmacharan, how did you get into me? Is this also the work of Asuras? This is really too bad and makes me feel like killing the Asuras immediately and joining the Devas. But tell me the whole story." Kach narrated it all in spite of the inconvenience imposed by his position. Vishampayana continued, "The high-souled and austere Shukracharya of immeasurable greatness became angry at the deceit practiced on him in his wine and proclaimed for the benefit of humanity, 'Virtue will desert the man who through lack of wisdom drinks wine. He will be an object of scorn to all. This is my message to humanity, which should be regarded as an imperative scriptural injunction.' Then he turned to his daughter Devyani and said, 'Dear daughter, here is a problem for you. For Kach to live, he must rend my stomach and come out of it, and that means death to me. His life can only be bought by my death.' Devyani began to weep and said, 'Alas, it is death to me either way. For if either of you perish, I shall not survive.' As Shukracharya sought a way out of the difficulty, the real explanation of it all flashed on him. He said to Kach, 'O son of Brihaspati, I now see with what object you come, and verily you have secured it. I must bring you out to life for the sake of Devyani, but equally for her sake, I must not die either. The only way is to initiate you in the art of Sanjeevani, so that you can bring me back to life after I shall have died, when a way is torn out through my entrails for you. You should employ the knowledge I am going to impart to you and revive me, so that Devyani need not grieve for either of us." Accordingly, Shukracharyas imparted the art of Sanjeevani to Kach. Immediately, Kach came forth from Shukracharya's body, emerging like the full moon from a cloud, while the great preceptor fell down, mangled and dead. But Kach at once brought Shukracharya back to life by means of his newly acquired Sanjeevani. Kach bowed down to Shukracharya and said, "The teacher who imparts wisdom to the ignorant is a father. Besides, as I have issued from your body, you are my mother too." Kach remained for many more years under the tutelage of Shukracharya. When the period of his woe ended, he took leave of his master and returned to the world of gods. As he was about to depart, Devyani humbly addressed him thus, "O grandchild of Angiras, you have won my heart by your blameless life, your great attainments and nobility of birth. I have loved you long and tenderly, even while you were faithfully following your vows of a brahmacharan. You should now reciprocate my love and make me happy by marrying me. Brihaspati as well as yourself are fully worthy of being honored by me." In those days, it was no uncommon thing for a wise and learned Brahmana ladies to speak out their minds with honorable frankness. But Kach said, "O faultless one, you are my master's daughter and ever worthy of my respect. I got back my life by being born out of your father's body. Hence, I am your brother. It is not proper for you, my sister, to ask me to wed you." Devyani sought in vain to persuade him. "You are the son of Brihaspati," said she, "and not of my father. If you have been the cause of your coming back to life, it was because I loved you, as indeed I have always loved you and wanted you as my husband. It is not fit that you should give up one like me, sinless and devoted to you." Kach replied, "Do not seek to persuade me to unrighteous. You are enchanting more so now than ever, flushed as you are with anger. But I am your brother. Pray bid me adieu. Serve into perfection ever and always, my master Shukracharya." With these words, Kach gently disengaged himself and proceeded to the abode of Indra, the king of gods. Shukracharya consoled his daughter. Chapter 4 finishes here. Keep listening further Mahabharata audio series in the next videos.